Hello everypony, Dale over here. Warning, this video will contain pictures from Google that is not mine, so please give respect to the owners of these pictures and copyrights. And also warning, it's going to contain my personal opinion and theory about what is going to happen into the future episodes of My Little Pony. So if you don't like stuff like this, click away or else stay. Yeah, here we go. 3, 2, 1. So we just saw Forex got a brother, or how to say that, he always had the brother, but his brother changed into the, you know, the good design, or how to say that. And I really was thinking about Celestia and Luna, and I must admit I saw Applekick's reaction today, and I was thinking about, like, now they're royal brothers and we have royal sisters. It could be a interesting episode if we had like Forex that came to Celestia and was like, we need, you know, queens for the hive, or I need a queen for the hive, and you know, my brothers also need something, I don't know. It could be interesting to have an episode that discuss, you know, how it is that you're supposed to fall in love, or you know how love works in Equestria. I know that, you know, that in old days the royal ones just married each other and stuff like that, and maybe, you know, Forex was grown up with this with his brother and have to go and ask Celestia or Luna for their hand, or I don't know. But it could be a very fun episode also to you know, that I think like Celestia will say no, and I also think like Luna will say no to the brother, and then we will have an episode with, you know, them, I will not say waging war, but them being like, we don't understand why love is not supposed to be like this way. We have always learned it to be like that. And that is also how I feel like they were feeding off, you know, the love and stuff like that. I do believe that it's because like they're just, you know, not aware of the other part also needs to give their, not consent, but their yes for, yeah, you know, take up my love, or how to say that, the way that Forex was forced to give all of his love to Queen Chrysalis was of course forced. But yeah, I also feel like that is a way to actually change the way that they you know, look upon the world, or how to say that. And now we have seen with Forex's brother that the only thing that they need is to actually love the hive, and you know, love to protect and stuff like that. So if Sunburst is really a changeling in disguise, or a changeling renegade, or how to say that, I do believe, like, why haven't he changed after the fact of Chrysalis being defeated? Did Chrysalis fly off and take him as the first thing? But that's not possible, because we see Sunburst in a future episode with Starlight, or it's a look into the future thing with Twilight. I'm actually not sure if we have seen Sunburst. Yeah, where's Sunburst? He's either he's hiding, or he's the changeling is thinking about freeing the real Sunburst. And that could also be a very interesting story, you know, Starlight actually admitting her attraction to Sunburst, and you know, the changeling feeling so much love so it could actually not hold its form and changed right in front of her, or how to say that. And there was no way, shape or form that she could actually, you know, do anything about it. And after the changing, we will find out that this is not like something that Starlight wants. So yeah, I don't know about you guys, but it could be a very interesting episode. It could also be very devastating for Starlight, and it could actually be a good revenge for Queen Chrysalis if she uses this against Starlight in some shape, way or form. I was actually thinking about her taking the appearance of Sunburst But if Sunburst is changeling and her, you know, what is that called? Best changeling, or how to say that? I do believe that he could actually, you know, suck up the love and stuff like that. But I don't know if he have actually already done this. If he, you know, that is the way that he was able to cast all of these great spells and stuff like that. But if he is a changeling, why would he save the Crystal Empire? Why would he, you know, go all through all of that just to be with Starlight? Maybe he is actually falling for Starlight, the changeling, and he doesn't know how to say to her that he is a changeling in disguise and, you know, stuff like that. Maybe that could also be an interesting episode about, you know, love and the truth and stuff like that. But I really want to see an episode with Celestia and Luna and Forex and his brother interacting. It could be so fun if it was like Forex coming to, you know, Queen Chrysalis or coming to Celestia and being like, I need a queen for my hive. Can you please, you know, help me? Or do you want to be my queen? And Celestia just being like, nope. Maybe he can also like ask Starlight, Trixie, or maybe Twilight, and they will of course all say no. It could be a good shenanigans episode, but it could also be a very emotional episode, episode that we would like, or I would like to see into the future of My Little Pony. And it could also, you know, teach not only children but us, or also us in the fandom, that love has all of these unique ways to be, or how to say that, you know, love for your friends, love for your family, and love for your boyfriend, girlfriend, and so on. So, and this with being forced to become a queen, or being forced into a relationship without you knowing it, if it's a good idea. Actually, I do believe maybe it could also be an episode where Forex comes and he gets rejected by Celestia, but, you know, Starlight is actually thinking about it and, you know, going along with it until she finds out that it's, you know, serious, or how to say that. Maybe she will think that it's just like a way for the changeling's custom, or how to say that, and she's like, if I can do anything to help, you know, the hive, or King Forex, or how to say that, into the future, I would like to do that. And, you know, her not having the connection with Sunburst no more, or else, like, I really like to ship those two. I really like that they're together, but we must see into the future. Like, I don't think like they have potential together. I don't know. I really hope that they will end up together and they will become a couple. Either, you know, Starlight and Sunburst, or Starlight and Trixie. It could be a very nice episode to have, where we actually get the, you know, some new couples, and we get some new forms of love, and you know, that could also be something that was too much for the changeling in disguise. So, for example, Sunburst, if you know, Trixie and Starlight found out that they actually loved each other, or how to say that, and the love was so strong, so it actually turned Sunburst also, or it turned like the you know, the changeling within Sunburst, or how to say that. It could be a very interesting episode, and I do believe that this could be something that Queen Chrysalis could definitely benefit from if she knew all of this. And I do believe that she's going to do her homework, and she's going to find out that Starlight has this attraction for Sunburst. Maybe not for Trixie, but yeah, she will definitely find out because if you're evil and you're going after somebody, you're not going after them, but you're going after somebody that they care about. if you are really evil. And I do believe that Queen Chrysalis sadly have the potential to do stuff like this. So going after Sunburst, Twilight, the main six, or Trixie is actually something I feel like she could do, or go after the old village again and actually try to turn them evil again. That would be heartbreaking for Starlight. But tell me in the comments what you think about this. Do remember that inspiration is right around the corner. Do remember to take care of yourself and loved ones. And there's not going to be reactions in this week. I just need to have a week where I'm not doing reactions. So that's actually all. But I will see all of you guys Monday the 11th. And there will be a surprise on my channel. Yeah, okay, yeah, that's actually all. Bye.